Hello everyone, Yanni Plays here, and today we got news from Minecraft. They just dropped a snapshot on the new world generation, so the very first 1.18 snapshot. Now this snapshot is a little bit different from the snapshots that we're used to use. You actually have to go and install this one as a separate version. This video I'm going to walk you through how to install it, and then we're going to start it up and we're going to look at a few of the changes. Now, on the Minecraft site, and I will put the link into the description so you can look at it yourself, you can see the changes that happened in this very first snapshot. Now, some of the features we already had in some of our 1.17 snapshots before Mojang made the decision to split the Caves and Cliffs update in two different parts. So, for example, the world height increase or the cave generation. So one big change that I want to point out is that now in 1.18, the terrain shape and the elevation is not connected to the biomes anymore. In 1.17 and the versions before, if we had a forest hills biome, then we knew, well, that's a forest and it has some hills. Well, in the future, we don't have to have those sub biomes anymore, because the new mountains are so big that they don't fit into those biomes anymore. And so the height generation now can be independent, or will be independent, from the biome itself. So you can see a desert that actually runs up the side of a new mountain. Now, according to Minecraft, some biomes are going to be blocked from certain areas, but we don't exactly know what that means yet. Another big change is the last point here, that monsters now only will spawn in complete darkness. Now here we have a visual guide on how this light level is going to affect the spawn rate. In the center on the green block I have a torch, and everything inside yellow is light level 7 or above. So that means there are no mobs going to spawn here in 1.17 and older versions. With 1.18, this non-spawn area is going to be extended all the way up here, where we have a light level of 1, so that means all those blue blocks now are also spawn-proof. Everything out in a black, mobs are going to spawn in 1.17 and in 1.18. Now, to install this new 1.18 snapshot, we have a very good description on the Minecraft webpage. However, I'm going to walk you through the steps really quick. First of all, you have to download the zip file, and I'm going to put the link for the zip file down into the description. Next, we have to find our Minecraft folder. If you don't know where your Minecraft folder is, then you can just go into your search bar and type in percentage app data percentage. And in this folder, usually the very first folder is .minecraft. Open up this folder and go into the versions folder. And in here, you now find all of the versions that you had installed on Minecraft. Once the zip file is downloaded, you can show it in a folder, open up the zip file, and here we have our 1.18 experimental snapshot. Now all we have to do is drag it over into our versions, and as you can see, the 1.18 experimental snapshot is now installed. Double click on it, and then you should see a JSON file. Now let's open up the Minecraft launcher. Once your launcher is started, go over to the installations, make sure that the modded is checked, and click on new installation. In here, you now can change to the pending 1.18 experimental snapshot 1. As you can see, now down here we have our 1.18 and we can start it up. Now, if you go into the single player, you will see that none of your old words are being compatible with this version, and that includes former snapshot versions that already had the increased world height. So we're creating a new world. So it took me about a minute to get this world generated, and I'm not expecting a very good frame rate because this version is not yet optimized. So it is not recommended to play on this version yet, because you are going to have a lot of lag, you're going to have a lot of frame dropping. But we already can see one of the bugs that was reported, that there are now a lot of microbiomes. So this one here, I am currently in a plains biome. And if I'm going over here, we have a very small snowy tundra. before we go over into a meadow. Now, the meadow is one of the new biomes that is being generated in parts of the mountains, and the meadows have a lot of flowers. So I believe that this one up here also would be a meadow, and I already see that it would be a perfect place to build some dye farms. The terrain change brought us also some changes in rivers, and we finally have some bigger, wider rivers. Unfortunately, still some areas that disconnect, but I really love to see those big rivers right next to some taller mountains. And what we already knew from the snapshots, we now have different water levels. The water does not necessarily have to generate at Y64, and it can generate in different heights. Another one of those microbiomes, so we have a jungle in the middle of Badlands. We also frequently come around structures that are generated completely outside of their biome. Now, the mountain generation itself has a few different biomes. We have the snowy slopes that we are on right now. And if we're getting here on the top of this mountain, we are on the snow-capped peaks. The snow-capped peaks are the ones with the ice on it. And then the peaks that we have with the snow on it, those will be the snow-capped peaks. We also have the grove now. The grove is at the side of the mountains and covered with a lot of trees. However, if we fly back to the center of this big mountain here, you can see that the center here actually is a birch forest generated here. In here, we also can see very well that caves now also generate in mountains, and sometimes we have quite large openings to get into those caves. On the caves itself, we have three new types of caves. We have the spaghetti cave, on what we're in right now. Those are the bigger caves. They are stretching through the mountains. The smaller squiggly ones that we have here, those are the noodle caves. And then the last cave is the cheese cave. The big open caverns that sometimes are filled with lava lakes or with water. Thank you so much for watching Yanni Plays. If you like this video, please give me a like, and I hope I see you at the next video. Goodbye.